Hey guys, Dr. Berg here. In this short video, we're going to talk about the relationship and the connection between cortisol and insulin. Okay, what is that connection? So I'm using CIBA Endocrinology Volume 4 to show you this connection on page 84. Okay, so here's what happens. The adrenal gland is a catabolic hormone. What does that mean? It means it's a hormone that breaks down proteins. So what it'll do, if there's too much cortisol, it will block protein from going into the muscle. So you will not be able to take these amino acids and stick them to the muscle. Instead, it's shunted to the liver, where it's broken down and converted into carbohydrates. That's called gluconeogenesis. It means making new sugar. Happens in the liver from the adrenal. So this is why you see so many issues with diabetes, insulin resistance, with cortisol. Now, in some of the other videos I talk about cortisol making belly fat, it's really the connection between cortisol making more insulin than making belly fat. So we really have a situation where the cortisol converts the converts protein to carbohydrate, spikes insulin, and creates the belly fat, diabetes, and cholesterol. So if you're eating really good and you're not losing weight, it could be coming from the cortisol, which is the stress hormone. Even if someone takes prednisone, which is a medical artificial synthetic cortisone, that can do it too. I'll see people that get treated with prednisone with some type of disease or autoimmune, and bam, they end up with diabetes because of this relationship. So it's just another connection I wanted to mention. So you might want to look into it if you have the situation. And I have a lot of videos on what to do about cortisol. Thanks for watching.